Mr. Bacon. Can I call you Mr. Bacon?
I prefer Kevin.
Right. So, Kevin, now that your magic spell got us talking and walking, well, what do we do now?
We try to fit into human culture. You know, the dominant culture? It's what the majority of humans think is acceptable. So, let's go out and party.
I'm not sure I'm great at partying. As a nice guy, my individual culture tells me that I'd rather stay indoors. You know, like reading the nutrition facts, having quiet time, all the usual yin stuff.
Yin? Well, I don't know what you mean about all that mumbo jumbo.
You know yin, the opposite of yang. It explains all things quiet, reserved, introspective, still, relaxed. Well, you're much more of a yang type fella, awake and excited. You're the go-getter, and that's exactly what I want
to
be.
Ah, you got that right. I'm here to go places, do stuff, and have a great time. Just like the commercials say. You know, like when mom watches TV in the kitchen? That's the life I want, little egg.
Yeah, just like the commercials. So are we best friends now?
Yeah, whatever, kid.
The name's Benedict, actually.
I like that. Hey, let's go pop into this here, fashion store.
I'm not great with fashion. What's in right now, Kevin?
Look at all the posters on the wall. We learn culture from the people around us. And since there's no people around us, these posters are the next best thing. If you need a friend, don't look to a stranger. You know in the end, I'll always be there. And when you're in doubt, and when you're in danger. Hi guys! You all set? Shouldn't your kids be in school?
We have a section 602. Copy that. I'm taking your kids in.
What are the odds that we run into a truancy officer at the fashion store?
Welcome to detention, gentlemen.
Alright, Benabuddy, be cool.
But it's just so cold in detention, Kevin.
Benny, quit being such a yin.
You're right, Kevin. I'm a yang now. Yang life.
Follow my lead. I watch television.
Hey guys, want some preservatives?
No thanks. My mom said I'm allergic.
Yeah, sure, dude. I'm all about preservatives. Benny, why don't you join us?
I'm cool, dudes.
No, Ben, you're really not.
Well, if that's how you feel.
Look, this is the fifth time in this whole trip that you started crying, and I'm sick of it, man. You need to beef up. And stop being such a scrambled egg.
You know, Kevin, maybe if you would just simmer down, we could...
No, maybe it's time we go our separate ways.
Finally, a chance to make my great escape.
Oh no.
What did I say about escaping? Blah, 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 blah.
I can't believe all of you trying to get out of detention.
We didn't do anything! We were sitting here the whole time!
You let Neville escape and you did nothing about it.
You're all rotten just like him. As punishment, I expect a letter from all of you about what you did wrong and about what you think you are as a person. You can't leave detention until those letters are given to me at the end of the day. I'm giving you this assignment because I know it's impossible for you all to work together considering your yin and yang differences. And I want you to suffer in here as long as possible.
I guess we're all gonna have to be in here for the rest of our lives.
Why don't we work on writing one really well-written letter for all of us?
Who's going to write it, exactly?
Well, I can write it, but I'll need some assistance. Let's form a circle and tell a story so I can get an idea of who everyone is.
I'll go first. All my life I've wanted to be athletic, but I'm just an egg.
I know I come off as a cool, outgoing, popular strip of bacon, but I wish others could see me as more than just another piece of meat.
Don't let the glasses fool ya. I'm not as much of a cool cat as everyone thinks I am.
I will never look as good as and as beautiful as the people on TV. Just look at my eyebrows. They're perry bushy.
As a woman, I've always been self-conscious about my facial hair. Just look at this goatee on my face.
Sitting here with all you guys, I realized that culture divides and unites us. At first I thought that being cool defined me. Then I got into fighting with my best friend and I saw how culture divided us. And now that I've learned about each and every one of you, I feel like I understand you a lot better. And I can see how culture can unite us all as a group of people, instead of, you know, turning ourselves against each other.
Do you really mean that, Kevin?
Yeah, buddy, I really do. Who cares about the dominant culture? We pals can form our own subculture. The kind of subculture where we make the rules.
I thought we all had individual culture. My culture isn't the same as yours. It's made up of old traditions and my own experiences.
You're right, Perry. But what we do all share is the ability to learn from one another. And that is the best part of culture, I think. We are all just bits and pieces of everyone we've ever met. Most of all, I'm just happy to be myself. I don't have to be all action all the time. I can be calm and collected in the same way that I can be totally vivacious in the life of the party.
All in moderation, my man. I'm glad I don't always have to be the cool guy. I can kick back and relax, just like my best friend taught me.
Now that's what I call balance. Dear Mr. Jello, we accept the fact that we had to sacrifice a Tuesday in detention for whatever it is we did wrong. What we did was wrong, but we think you're crazy to make us write an essay telling you who we think we are. You see us as you want to see us, in the simplest terms, the most convenient definitions. But what we found out is that each and every one of us is a little yin with a little yang. We balance each other out, and that's a healthy way of living. Does that answer your question? Sincerely yours, The Breakfast Society.